studente macedone scopre che nella sua città i livelli di inquinamento sono preoccupanti e la qualità dell'aria è pessima. È per questo che decide di creare un'applicazione per risolvere il problema. Play Digital vi racconta la sua storia.
So my name is Gorjan Jovanovski. I come from the capital of North Macedonia called Skopje. I am a software engineer by trade and an eco-activist by heart. And I am currently 29 years of age. My project in 30 seconds is basically a mobile app called AirCare, which helps you know what you breathe. The way that AirCare works is that it aggregates a lot of pollution data that comes from government monitoring stations, volunteer monitoring stations, and even satellites from the sky, and puts it all together in the palm of your hand so you know exactly what you're breathing and should you leave your home or stay inside where the air is cleaner. The next step is to not only be a passive, let's say, consumer of this information and just say, oh, well, I'm going to stay indoors and that's all I can do, but we want you to be an active participant in the fight for clean air. Some of the things you can do, of course, the let's call them the easier ones, is to change your lifestyle. So to make sure that you're using more walking or bike as your transportation method, make sure that your heating in your home is not burning wood, but maybe is using more electrical appliances. But then comes the harder part, where it is that you should be lobbying to those in charge which are supposed to be changing the air around you. So we're talking from local government to central government, to ministries that are all involved in the fight for clean air. So AirCare initially originated from North Macedonia and was only working here, but we've been very lucky to grow both the team of activists working behind it and the support from the community to be able to expand to 45 countries around the world, covering Europe, North America, and slowly now expanding towards Asia and South America. Through AirCare, what you can also do is connect to local NGOs and eco-organizations that are working on this topic and volunteer your time and effort together with them in this bigger cause to make sure that your city and hopefully your country and the world will have better and cleaner air in the future. According to my research, air quality in Italy is under the standard, let's call it, of what would be the European average of air pollution. So we see in Italy that there are a lot of parts where air pollution is higher and above average limits that the European Environmental Agency has set as standards for, let's call it, clean air. Even though this year the World Health Organization declared that there is no limit for clean air and only zero pollutants would constitute clean air. Everything else is not safe. Unfortunately, Italy is not the only country in the world and in Europe facing these issues. One of the ways that AirCare became very viral, or let's say two ways, was A, simplifying the access to this data about air quality and what you breathe. And the second one was making sure that all of this data that you now get, you can easily understand. So you don't have to be a scientist to look at all these numbers and say, what does this mean? Is this bad or good? But the very way that AirCare displays this data in a very simple and effective format helps you know what you breathe and makes sure that this goes viral. A lot of type of people use AirCare. We have standard citizens which are eco-conscious and want to know how the air quality is outside, that have heard that there might be a problem with their air quality and want to get informed. Also, NGOs, so non-government organizations, that use this app as a tool to propagate their message about the importance of clean air going forward. Even government institutions in some countries use the app to make sure that they are either doing their job or even go out in press conferences and show the app and say, hey, look, it's good or bad now, and we must take things much more seriously.